This conference will now be recorded.
Hi, welcome back. Srinivas here. So now we are going to learn the basics of share market. What is share actually? What is share? And what is stock? A share is a part of the company's capital, which means if you have one share of a company, you are one of the equity holder of the company, one of the shareholder of the company. So how can we define a share? How come it will be available in the public? Say for example, you want to run a company. You have started a company with 10 crores of capital, and then you are running your business very smoothly and profitably. After some years, you want to expand your business. For that, you need 100 crores of money, but you don't have. Then what you want to do? You need to collect fund from the public, either from your relatives or friends or from the public. But when you want to collect it from the friends and relatives, it may not reach your requirement. It may not fulfill your requirement. So then you go to public issue. So if you want to go to public issue, there is an authority called SEBI, Securities and Exchange Board of India. You need to approach SEBI and you need to seek permission from SEBI to go to public issue to collect fund from public. So once SEBI approves your request, you go on public. You come up with some brochures, just like explaining your background, your family background, your qualifications, and what is your business, how is your business right now, and who are your opponents, competitors, and how come you are going to run your business smoothly. All those things you need to explain, and then you have to come out for a public issue. So when you are out for a public issue, based on your background and all, people will buy shares. Normally it may be 10 rupees, otherwise according to the company value you can decide a particular price. Usually it would be 10 rupees per share. So once you offer shares to your Once you offer shares to the public, they buy your shares. It may be 1 or 10 or 100 or thousands of lakhs. So where you will attract public to be a shareholders of your company, I will explain you in this later. But whereas when it comes to a share, a share is a particular one share or two shares, three shares of a company. But when it comes to stock, there may be shares or bonds, mutual funds, derivative contracts, everything. So when only shares are being traded, that is called share market. When there are bonds, mutual funds, derivatives, contracts along with shares also being traded, that is called stock market. So shares can be traded in market usually in two ways. One is primary market and the second one is secondary market. Primary market means already I told you. Once you get the permission from SEBI, you will sell your shares to the public very in the first time. So that is called primary market. The first time you issue shares, that is primary market. That is called as initial public offer, IPO. And later on, if anyone wants to buy or sell that particular company shares, they are available in the secondary market. Why? Once you, as a company chairman or managing director, issue the shares, you cannot issue the shares again and again and again. Once you issued, that's it. After that, if anyone wants to buy or sell, the transaction has to be done in between two traders only. Which means, if I have shares, and if you want, you can buy from me, not from the company. Company cannot sell you again. Anyone wants to buy shares, they need to buy from the other person who holds the shares. The same way, if anyone wants to sell the shares, then he need to sell those shares to the someone else in the market. Okay, so that is why secondary market is required. So either primary market or secondary market, if you want to buy or sell trades, there is an exchange, the place where you can buy and sell instruments like shares, bonds, mutual funds and all. So the oldest one in India is Bombay Stock Exchange, BSE, and the next National Stock Exchange, NSE. But now the most popular one is National Stock Exchange. Though Bombay Stock Exchange is the oldest one, National Stock Exchange is holding major part in Indian stock market. So this is all about stock market. So when it comes to trading shares, what are the types of market? The first one is already we know, that is cash market or equity market. When any company issues shares to the public through initial public offer, they will be traded in the secondary market later on. So they are in cash form. That is called cash market, where people can buy and sell shares. In cash market, you can buy any number of shares. If you want to buy one share, you can buy. If you want to buy 100 shares, you can buy. If you want to buy 1 lakh shares also, you can buy. And you can take the delivery of that shares also. Previously, physical certificates were there. Once if you buy any company shares, they use it to issue those share certificates later on to you. Sometimes it used to take 1 month or 45 days also. Right now, DMAT accounts are there, digital accounts, so that within 2 days of the trading, those shares will be transferred to your DMAT account. Okay, so you can take delivery in cash market. And as well, you can hold them as long as you want. If you want, you can keep them for 1 week. If you want, you can keep them for 1 month or 1 year or years together. You can keep those shares along with you. Okay. And cash market is the main market. Based on cash market, only derivatives market will move. So then what is derivatives market? Derivatives are insurance to the cash market. Actually, this concept, derivatives market concept, has been adapted from the farmers. Cash market is the main market, and derivatives market actually is an insurance. Actually, this concept has been adopted from the farmers. Say, for example, if any farmer yield some crop, say for example banana crop. At present, say for example, the yield of a banana tree may be 100 rupees. Once you plant the banana plant, someone may come and ask you to sell them after a future time. Once they come to the yield, immediately, as soon as you plant the banana plant, he will approach you and ask you to buy at a future rate. Say for example, if he says 100 rupees, you and that particular person comes to an understanding, an agreement. So after that particular period of yielding time, whatever the price it may be, you need to sell it to the person who entered into the contract for the same price. Say for example, right now if you enter into the contract for 100 rupees, you need to sell it at 100 rupees only. Even at that time, market price may be 120 or 150 rupees, but you need to sell at 100 rupees only. And at the same way, even if the price of that particular yield 80 rupees also, that guy has to buy from you at 100 rupees only, because you made that contract as an insurance, because in future you don't know what would be the price, so that you had an agreement with him that he will buy that particular yield at 900 rupees. So at least you are insured for some price. Whatever the market price may be, you will get 100%, you will get 100 rupees for sure. And the particular guy who entered into contract with you, the benefit is, if the price is at 120 or 150 rupees also, he need to give you only 100 rupees. So that is the advantage to him. So you are the owner of that particular product, producer of that particular product, and he entered into agreement by promising you a particular price in future. So that is called derivatives market. In this case, the guy who entered into the agreement with you is called a seller or writer. He is a seller or a writer. So he made an agreement with you, and in future, whatever the price it may be, he will give you the price which has been entered into the agreement. Okay, so that is called derivatives market. The same concept has been adapted into the cash market, stock market also. So you and another person can come to an agreement for the future contract. Why this concept has been introduced into stock market? All these are olden days. Previously, when there was no derivatives market, people used to buy shares and hold them as long as they want. Say, for example, you bought one particular company share at 100 rupees, and now that share is moving at 150 rupees. At this point of time, you may feel like price may go down a little bit. Remember, you bought at 100 rupees and right now price is at 150, but you feel like price may go down for 10 rupees or 20 rupees. But you don't want to sell your shares. then how to protect from that particular fall. That is why derivatives contracts have been introduced. You don't need to sell that particular shares, but you can sell a derivative contract. Say for example, SBI is there. If SBI share is 300 rupees, and if you hold 3000 shares, which means worth 9 lakh rupees shares, then you don't need to sell your shares, but you can sell a derivatives contract. You can sell a derivatives contract for a future price. So after you enter into the derivatives contract, if price goes down by 20 rupees, say SBI share, price goes down by 20 rupees, then what happened? Your cash market share value has become down. But at the same time, by selling a derivatives contract, you made some money, that 20 rupees profit. So as soon as you think that, okay, that fall is over, you will close that derivatives contract and your shares already hold shares are alive with you. Again, if market goes up, your share value will be increased. So when at particular time of fall, you made some money by selling a derivatives contract. Okay, what are the types of derivative contracts? In derivatives contract, you cannot buy one or two shares. You cannot sell one or two shares. You have to buy or sell them in lot sizes. In lots only you can buy or sell, not in sing 1, 2, 3 or something like this. In Indian stock market, based on the price of the stock, lot sizes have been designed. National Stock Exchange or Bombay Stock Exchange, they will decide what is the lot size. Lot size may be differ from each and every stock. Approximately a one lot size of the price, particular price, may be around 5 lakhs to 10 lakhs. Say for example, as I talked about SBI, if SBI price is 300 rupees, 3000 shares is a one lot. So which means 3000 multiplies by 300, which means 9 lakh rupees, that particular lot size, price of the lot size. Okay, we can buy or sell in lots only, not individually. And delivery is not possible in derivatives market. You can't take the shares physically in derivatives market. They will have some expiry date. By that expiry date, you need to close that contract. So what are the expiry dates? We have three types of contracts. 1 month contract, 2 months contract, and 3 months contract. Of course, in US market, 12 months contracts also there. But in India, 1 month, 2 months, and 3 months contracts will be there. Each and every contract will be closed in the last working Thursday of the month. Remember, last working Thursday of the month is the expiry date. If Thursday, last Thursday is holiday, before day. If last Wednesday, then is holiday, before day. Like that, the contract will be expired in the last working Thursday. And the next contract will be opened in the next working day of the expiry. Say for example, if you take one particular month's expiry day, last working Thursday, is 25th. So on 25th, that contract will be closed, and the next contract will be opened on 26th Friday. For any reason, if Friday is holiday, Monday will be the next opening day of the new contract. Okay, in derivatives market, 1 month, 2 months, 3 months contracts will be expired on the last working Thursday. It is not that you entered into the contract on 1st, 2nd, 3rd or 15th, whatever it may be. That contract will be closed by the last working Thursday. And there may be a question. Can you close that contract in between? Yes, you can close. You don't need to wait up to the expiry date of the particular contract. If you want, you can exit at any point of time. Say, for example, you entered in a particular contract today, and if you want, you can exit tomorrow also. But you cannot hold that particular contract after expiry day. Okay, so these are the contracts: 1 month contract, 2 months contract, and 3 months contract. Last working Thursday is the expiry day, and the next working Friday is the opening of the next contract. If Friday is holiday, next working day, it may be Monday, or Monday is also holiday, Tuesday, right? So this is derivatives market. And again, when it comes to derivatives market, there are two types of markets. One is futures market and the other one is options market. We will talk about options in the last modules. So first we will talk about futures. As we discussed about the contracts, you can enter into cash market, you can enter into futures market, and you can enter into options market also. So options is particularly a different topic. We will learn that topic in the last module. Okay, but for now, futures are contracts just like insurance. But after that, these futures are being traded. These futures are being traded to speculate the market. Once upon a time, futures market is an insurance. Already you have some shares in your hand, and if you expect some fall in the market, you enter into your future contract. That was the past. But now people are entering into futures market to speculate the market. Why speculation? Because in cash market, if you want to buy some shares, you need to pay 100% of the money. That is called cash and carry. If you want 3000 SBI shares, you need to pay 9 lakh rupees and you have to buy. But when it comes to futures, you don't need to pay the whole money. Just like as I told you about a farmer, banana farmer, the particular guy who enters into the contract need not pay all 100 rupees. He will pay some advance and enter into the contract. And at the time of expiry, he will pay the remaining balance. Which means by paying a little money to the farmer, he entered into the whole contract. The same way in futures market also, you don't need to pay the whole money to enter into the contract. Broker will give you some leverage based on that. If you can pay 1/5 to 1/10 of that particular value, you can enter into a futures contract. Which means Say, for example, 3000 shares value of SBI shares is 9 lakh rupees. But by paying 1,35,000 rupees to the broker, you can enter into the futures contract. You don't need to pay the full amount. You can pay only 1,35,000 rupees, which means 6th part of the value or 7th part, 1/6 or 1/7. Okay, I hope you have the idea of broker. Otherwise, I will explain what is the hierarchy of the stock market. First one is SEBI controls the market, and once SEBI issues a permission to sell shares, the main person here is the exchange, NSE or BSE. After that, directly you cannot open an account with that particular exchange. There are brokers in the middle. So if you want to open any account, you need to approach a broker, stock broker. So through him only you will trade. So if you want to open an account, you need to open a demat account first. Once you open demat account, you can buy and hold shares. Otherwise, you can directly enter into the futures market also. Okay, so when it comes to futures market, you don't need to pay full money of the value of the stocks. So what is the advantage? I used the word speculation. Where the speculation comes? Say, for example, by investing 9 lakh rupees on 3000 SBI shares, after that, if market moves by 1 rupee, you have 3000 shares, so that you make 3000 rupees of profit. Your investment was 9 lakh rupees. You made 3000 rupees profit, which means 0.33%. In the other case, after investing 1,35,000, otherwise say 1,50,000, if you enter into the futures market, if SBI shares moves by 1 rupee up, you will make again 3000 rupees, but here your investment is 1,50,000 rupees only. On 1,50,000 rupees, you made 3000 rupees profit, which means 2% on your equity. Understand this. You buy 3000 shares in cash market. After that, market moved by 1 rupee to the upside, and you made 3000 rupees profit on 9 lakh rupees equity. Again, the same way, market moved by 1 rupee to the upside and you made 3000 rupees, but here your equity investment is 1,50,000 rupees. So by investing 1,50,000 rupees, you made 3000 rupees profit. So this is called speculation. Less investment and high profits. So once upon a time it was an insurance, now it becomes speculation. Nowadays people are using futures market for the speculation only, most of the people. But the other side of the market, other side, we talked about profit. If it goes against, if it comes down by 1 rupee, then what happens? When it comes to cash market, if you lose 3000 rupees on your 9 lakh rupees, 0.33% loss. But when it comes to futures market, if you lose 3000 rupees on 1.5 lakh rupees investment, you lose 2%. So that is why only very in the beginning session I advised you to decide what is the percentage you expect from the market. If you expect a little percentage, your risk is also reduced. If you expect a good return, your risk is also increased. So that is why you need to decide what percent of the profit you are expecting on your equity. Okay. Just a minute. Shall I explain you later? Yeah. All right. So I hope you understood this. What is share market and what is stock market? What is primary market and what is secondary market? All the tradings will happen in secondary market only. Only at the time of initial public offer, we enter into primary market to buy directly from the company. Once the initial public offer is over, all tradings will be happened, transactions will be happened in secondary market only through the exchange. Okay, so we have cash market, derivatives market. In derivatives market, again, we have futures and options. We will discuss about options in the later subjects, later modules. And we have expiry dates for every contract, 1 month contract, 2 months contract, and 3 months contract. If you have any doubts on this 1 month contract, 2 months contract, and 3 months contract, I will explain. Say, for example, now if you enter in the 1 month contract, say, for example, 25th of this month is a last working Thursday. This 1 month contract will be closed on that particular day. Otherwise, if you enter into the 2 months contract today, next month last working Thursday is the closing of that particular contract. Next month, because you entered in the 2 months contract. And if you enter into the market 3 months contract, this month is the present month contract, next month is second month contract, and after that next month is going to be the expiry date of your 3 months contract. Okay, once this month contract closes, another contract will be added. Like that, every time we will have three months contracts. Okay, if you enter into market in 1 month contract, you enter into this month's contract only. That contract will be expired in this particular month, last working Thursday. Okay, so, but most of the traders trade in 1 month contract in India. Most of the traders enter into the market in 1 month's contract only. In US market, we can see in 6 months contract, 8 months contract, 1 year contracts also, so much of liquidity will be there. But when it comes to Indian market, Indian stock market, most of the traders are available in 1 month contract only. In 2 months contract and 3 months contract, liquidity will be less. Okay, what is liquidity? Tomorrow we will discuss about liquidity and leverage and other aspects. Okay, so this is 8:14 right now. So we will close this topic today. And tomorrow we will discuss about advantages of the market and who participate in the market. Already I told you, institutional traders, and what is the lot size and what is the leverage, and very important, bid and ask price. What is the connection with liquidity? Bid and ask price and connection with the liquidity. All those things will be taught in the tomorrow session. Okay, and the next session we will discuss about all those topics, other topics. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.